And at last he vanishes. The six kind of changes. Not only the six kind of changes, but also there are many tribulations. They are called threefold miseries, pertaining to the body, pertaining to the mind. Miseries offered by other living entities, miseries happening by natural disturbances, and after all, the whole thing is summarized into four principles, namely birth, death, old age, and disease. These are our conditional life. So, in order to get out of these conditions of life, if we revive our Bhagavad consciousness or Krishna consciousness or God consciousness, whatever you like, when we speak of Krishna, means the Supreme Lord, God consciousness, Krishna consciousness, or our original consciousness. Just like every one of us, we remember always that I am the son of such and such gentleman. Such and such gentleman is my father. It is natural to remember one's father and his relationship with father. And in ordinary business also, the etiquette is, if one presents his identification, he has to give his father's name. In India, it is very essential. And the father's name or the title is the last name of everyone. So, when we forget the Supreme Father, Krishna, and we want to live independently. Independently means if we want to enjoy life according to my whims. Oh. That is called so-called independence. But by such independence we are never happy. So we transmigrate for this so-called illusionary happiness from one body to another. Because a particular body has got a particular facility of happiness. Just like every one of us, we want to fly in the sky. But because we are human beings, we have no wings, we cannot fly. But the birds, although they are animals, lower animals, they can easily fly. In this way, if you make analytical study, every particular body has got a particular type of facility, while others haven't got. But we want all facilities of life. That is our inclination. Just like modern scientists, they're trying to go to other planets. But their condition, they cannot go. We can see there are millions and trillions of planets before us. The sun planet, the moon planet, the Venus, the Mars. Sometimes you wish how I could go there. But because I am conditioned, I am not independent, I cannot. But originally, because you are spirit soul, originally you were free to move anywhere. Just like Narad Muni, Narada Muni moves everywhere. Any planet he likes, he can go. Still, there is one planet within this universe which is called Siddha Loka. That Siddha Loka, the inhabitants of Siddha Loka, they can fly from one planet to another without any aeroplane. Even yogis, hatha yogis, those are practice, they can also go from anywhere to any place. The yogis, they sit down in one place and immediately transfer in another place. They take a dip in some river nearby here, and they can get up in some river in India. They dip here and they rise there. These are yogic powers. So we have got immense independence, but we are now conditioned by this body. Therefore, in the human form of life, it is an opportunity to get back our original independence. That is called Krishna consciousness, freedom. When we have got our spiritual body, without being covered by this material body, we have got our spiritual body within this material body, very small. That is my real identification. Now I am covered by two kinds of material bodies. One is called subtle body and the other is called gross body. The subtle body is made of mind, intelligence and ego, false ego. And the gross body is made of earth, water, fire, air and ether mixed together, this body. So two kinds of body we have got. And we are changing. Generally we can see the gross body, we cannot see the subtle body. Just like everyone knows, I know that you have got your mind. I know that you have got intelligence. You know, I have got mind, I have got intelligence. But I cannot see your mind, I cannot see your intelligence. I cannot see your determination. I cannot see your thoughts, thinking, feeling and willing. Similarly, you cannot see. You see my gross body, made of this earth, water, air, fire, and I can see your gross body. Therefore, when this gross body is changed and you are carried, you go away by the subtle body, and that is called death. We say, oh, my father has gone away. How do you see that your father has gone away? The body is here lying. But actually his father has gone away by the subtle body. Just like at night, we are sleeping in our nice apartment, but the subtle body takes me away on the top of a mountain. Sometimes, you see, I come in dream. I have come on the top of a mountain, very high, and I am falling down. Although, actually, my gross body is sleeping in a nice, comfortable apartment. But the subtle body carries me. You have got daily experience. Similarly, death means this gross body will change. That's why you have got your sat and core. So you change the core, but you keep your sat. You do it, generally. Similarly, I keep my subtle body, and I give up my gross body. That is called death. And I am carried by the subtle body in the womb of another mother by the laws of nature, and I develop another gross body, material supplied by the mother. And when the body is prepared, I come out of the womb of mother and I work again with that subtle and gross body. And Bhagavad Dharma means that we have to transcend both the gross and subtle body, come to the spiritual body. It is very scientific. And as soon as we come to the spiritual body, mukta sanga, being free from the gross and subtle body, we come to a real body, spiritual body, then actually we feel happiness and independence. So this process of Krishna consciousness is the highest benediction for the human society, because it is trying to bring the human being to the platform of spiritual body, transcending the gross and subtle material world. That is the highest part.